Yo guys, what's going on, Sniper Ads here, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Here we'll be discussing a lot of market strategies, a lot of hints, tips and tricks you guys can use to become profitable traders. We'll be going through a lot of retail methods, a lot of institutional methods, and hopefully finding the best balance between the two of them, so you guys can become profitable traders in the future yourselves. But before I do that guys, I'd really appreciate it if you guys could drop a follow on my socials. Everything is at Sniper Ads. I'd appreciate if you could drop a like, a sub, and a comment in the section below if you think this video helped you, if you found anything useful in this video at all. And lastly guys, there is a free Telegram link, free Telegram channel in the description below. It's the first link. In that channel guys, I basically post a lot of free signals, forex and synthetics. I talk about a lot of my services, like my VIP and my mentorship, and as well as that guys, I do just post regularly regarding any of the market insights that I believe you guys can benefit off in the future. So yeah, without further ado guys, let's get straight into it. As you guys can see, we'll jump into the FTMO side of things because that's the title of the video. As you guys can see, the FTMO challenge, the $10,000 account challenge, it was passed by myself in only 4 days out of the 30. And as you guys can see here, the first day was only 1% gain, and I was only actually scalping here simply because I came off a loss on my previous FTMO challenge, where I was actually up by only 9.4% with the target being 10, and then I just scrapped it all simply because my mindset wasn't right and I was just scrapping my strategy and going after the money rather than the pips. So yeah, as you can see, I wouldn't recommend the first day. That was just scalping purely. Using my same strategy, however, just on smaller time frames and securing profits way too early. So as you guys can see though, however, on the second day, which was a Tuesday, my favorite day to trade, as you guys can see, it was a 7.13% gain on the account, which is huge, with actually a lower lot size than the day before. And I'll be going through the trade that I took on this day, which is basically the trade setup and the strategy that I've been using throughout the FTMO challenge, and just in my journey throughout, the last sort of few months that I've been trading with this one strategy, and it's really been helping. So yeah, let's get into the chart. As you can see guys, the one symbol or the one pair that I was trading was GU, and I believe if you look at the metrics again, the symbol there's GU, there's EU, and the rest is sort of NZD and the little indices here that I've just been adding little lot sizes onto. If you guys are curious regarding these losses, these are simply just the minimal lot sizes that I've been using to achieve the minimum trading days. So yeah, as you guys can see here, I put it in the chart and replay mode so you guys can see what went down on the 27th of July, where I took my one of my best trades. And as you guys can see here, what I first of all did, which I fully would recommend to you guys, is simply marking out the chart, before making any decisions or drawing anything else. This little arrow tool is one of my favorite tools on TradingView. Highly would recommend everyone gets the premium option on TradingView. Simply you can rewind the chart and just backtest. So guys, I'm just gonna go quickly through a little diagram with you guys and show you what an uptrend is defined by and what a downtrend is defined by. It's very simple. And don't worry guys, if you're getting bombarded or you're thinking the terminology is a bit too advanced, do not worry. I'll be going through each one of these little bits of information that I'm giving you guys in a lot more of the videos. So not to worry, I'll be going through a lot of them, or everything I'm talking about now, just in the few more videos throughout the week. So guys, an uptrend, that's simply defined by price making higher highs and higher lows. So as you can see, this is price at the beginning, it makes a high. Okay, cool, we've now established what the impulse is. What happens next is where we define the next sort of moves to the market. So as you can see, this low was higher than this previous low, and then this high was actually broke this previous high and made a higher high. So we just call this a higher high, and we call this a higher low. Again, we call this a higher low simply because it didn't break this previous low by going to the downside. If price however had done something like this, then it would not be classed as a higher low, it'd be classed as a lower low. But price did something like this, and then again it went to the upside. A downtrend however, that's defined again just through lows, just like this. So you see a high here, you see a low here, you see a lower high compared to this, then you see a lower low compared to this, then you see a lower high compared to this previous impulse, then you see a lower low compared to this impulse. And that way, guys, all you're doing is you're just marking the market out, and you're simply understanding where the price is changing and where price is going. So if we were to sort of come back to this point here, we could see prices making an uptrend, and then we can see, if I just make the chart like this, so bear with me. If the chart was like this, we'd see that price is in an uptrend, and then we can see a break of a low has begun. So the ideas for a possible retracement to the upside before it continues in its intended direction is possible. So as you guys can see, price will hit certain levels and then continue its downwards journey. So it's that simple, guys. I'm just obviously going to delete this little illustration. I hope you understood a little bit from that. Don't worry, again, we will be going in a lot more depth in future videos. So as you can see here, guys, on the 4-hour chart, I simply marked out big moves like this here. What we noticed was a double top formation here, and I noticed a breakout structure to the downside violating this previous low. So my next sort of call to action was whether I will take the retracement to the upside or whether I will wait for the retracement and take the trades downwards. Now, it'd be the wisest thing to do here was simply to trade the move upwards, because we've only got 30 days to do the FTMO challenge and I'm not looking to waste any time. So before you guys start getting confused with all these lines in the charts, I'm actually just going to delete them all for you and show you what I was looking at simply. So again, the same principles applies here on the 1 hour. We're just going to be looking at the first around this sort of region here, around half the page, and we're just going to be looking at what price did and where it's looking to go. So again, like I said on the 4 hour, there was a break to the downside, and it is possible for a move to come to the upside to certain levels before it continues in its intended direction. So again, on the 1 hour, it's going to take longer to complete that move for the 4 hour. So what would be the wisest thing would be to simply ride the wave up there. Now, what I spotted was that the 4 hour was looking for a retracement, therefore on the 1 hour and the 15 minute, it would be a simple case of a reversal occurring. So we're just looking for each retracement to the upside and going that way. But again, like I did mention on the 4 hour chart, we're simply looking to mark our moves out, you know, and then expect certain moves to the upside or anywhere else. So as you guys can see here, what I did was I simply marked my moves out from here, and on the 1 hour, it's a very, very clean interface, and you can just see things a lot cleaner. Now we're going to hop into the 15 minute and show you guys the little bit more sort of in-depth look at things. It's what I was looking at on the 15 minute. I'd highly recommend you guys, if you are day traders and you're looking to sort of trade throughout the day, the 5, 15 minute, 1 hour, they're just key. They're beautiful to work with, and they work every time. So as you guys can see here, we were making clear lows, lower highs compared to the previous highs, and then lower lows compared to the previous lows. But then once we reached the 1.357 level, I noticed a crazy reaction. I saw this high was violated by this one. This previous low did not actually break the previous, this low did not break the previous low, and therefore making this current low a higher low compared to this previous low. So then we can take our chances and understand that price is looking to move to the upside. And since its start, it's not made a single lower low to indicate bearish momentum. So as you guys can see here, price is making really nice movements to the upside, and it was almost like a staircase, if you guys can imagine, down and up, down and up, and that's where I was looking to take my trade. Now, as you guys can see, I'm gonna hop back into the 1 hour. As you guys can see, this is not only the only, just tracing out the moves was not the only thing I used. I used the horizontal rectangle, well, sorry, the horizontal lines. I'd simply use a rectangle for this. I'm gonna just change it to a different color now. Let's change it to gray. So as you guys can see here, the one thing that I was doing is I was marking out my support and resistance. And again, guys, if you don't know what support and resistance is, do not worry, do not worry. We'll be going through them in separate videos. And the best way to do this, guys, is simply jump into your line chart and find out points where price, where the bodies, because this is what the line chart will display to you guys, is where price reacted off, maybe from the upside to the downside, and again, opposite way around here. So we're looking for price, places where price touched down on one side, and ideally we're hit on the opposite side again. So as you can see, why is this level key? Well, we can see that price actually rejected off it here, and it rejected off it here. So this looks like a key level, and we're just going to keep replicating this in areas where we believe a lot of traffic is, as you can see here, a lot of resistance here, and then a lot of support here. So we're going to use this as one little area, and again, as you guys can see here, it was used as support again. We're just going to keep following this market up right up here. So if I just show you guys this area here, why? Because I've seen this little point of interest here, I've seen a little bit of support here, so support here, resistance here, a bit of traffic around that area there, and then again we've seen some resistance there. So all I'm doing now at this point, guys, is I'm just marking out my range, looking at areas where I believe price can react off or break. So it can either react off or it can break. So as you guys can see here, very simply it reacted off here, but at this point it broke. Why? Because it's used as previous resistance, and that way we're building our foundation for a more stronger confluence when taking our trade. So now that we've marked out our support and resistance levels, so these key points of interest, and we've now understood which way the market's going, we're about halfway there to sort of getting our trade in there, and being very almost 100% confident in it. Now, as you guys can see, if I just jump into the 15-minute, this is where once my levels are marked and I've made an understanding as to where price is looking to go, I will jump into the 15-minute and start looking at price action and a few more other indicators. Now, at this point, I simply brought out the Fibonacci level and I marked out the break of structure and looking for a zone to retest in. Now, not only did I use the Fibonacci, but I also used a trend line. And as you can see here, guys, there was a clean reaction of this zone or this trend line, which I plotted here very, very simply. And all I did was I parallel lined it to the opposite side, and I could see that it matched. So this helped build my confidence again. This is not something we'll be taking trades off solely. We won't be looking at trend lines and thinking, okay, just because it reacted at this area, we'll be taking a trade right here. That is very dangerous, very risky. And again, guys, trend lines are just basically very subjective. It's all about how you draw them. So you don't want to be taking trades off them. You just want to be using them as trade confluence. Now, as you can see, my Fibonacci level is lined up not only with a supply and demand level, but again with that trend line. So that helps strengthen my belief in this trade and my confluence. And on top of that, guys, the last bit of confluence that I added to myself before I took this trade was an institutional level here known as an order block. That's something we get into depth with in the mentorship, and something why we refine our entries to the complete minimal level, to almost zero drawdown. If I just show you here, I'm changing the color of the long position. I just do it again, sorry. There you go, a nice bearish order block before the breakout structure to this side. I believe this was a London breakout session, something where prices, propels off, comes back for a quick retest and then continues. And I was very keen to take this entry here. However, patience does pay, and I simply just waited for a retest to this level. So I'm just gonna draw it out for you guys so you guys can see a little bit better. I'm just gonna get this Fibonacci for now. I'm just gonna draw it out so as you guys can see. Downtrend, higher lows, break to the upside, and then higher lows from this point onwards, as you guys can see. So we were simply looking for this zone to be entered on or sniped, and then we were looking to the upside. And things like this order block, guys, that's something we do get down on again in the mentorship, and just in a bit more depth. That's a nice little way to refine your entry. So as you guys can see, let's see what price did from this point onwards. It did come down with a lot of bullish momentum downside with big red candles, but this was not something that fazed me. Why? Because we'd initially previously marked out the direction of the market. We'd back this up on a higher time frame analysis, and we'd also marked up our supply and demand levels. We've marked up our trend lines, we've marked up our Fibonacci, we've marked up our institutional level. So guys, as you can see, there's a lot of confluence going for this trade. And remember, obviously, guys, there is money being put on this line here, on the line here. So we're going to be looking to go into this trade, or any trade in general, from whenever you're trading, with a clear mind, with a fresh mind, with a very alert mind. We're not going to be taking trades off only a couple of confluences. We're going to look for around 3 or 4 strong confluences before we take a trade, and that way is the only way you're going to be profitable. So as you guys can see, price came down with a lot of intent and actually sniped my entry right there. As you guys can see, I think I got 1.37669, I believe. I just try and trace it down, 668, as you guys can see here. on the metrics, if I scroll down to the 27th of July, as you guys can see here, one lot on a 37669, that's basically around here, 37668, call it right there. Basically no drawdown, as you guys can see, and just straight into profit. And obviously we refined our entry here. We could have had a less stop loss, we could have had around 3 pip stop loss, 3 or 4 pip stop loss. I gave myself a little bit more room. I gave myself around a 10 pip stop loss. Why? Because I thought once this trend line is broken, that's when I'll look to get out of the trade. But as you guys can see, it respected our analysis with the previous resistance zone that has now become a support zone before it propels in our direction. And believe it or not, guys, I actually took this trade and closed it within 20 pips only, and that gained me the 7%. If I let this running just a couple of hours more, it would have passed me the challenge with flying colors, as you guys can see, and it actually went on by a few hundred pips, as you guys can see there. And that's obviously why I call myself Sniper Ads, guys. If you haven't noticed by now, we're getting in trades like this all the time. If it's not Forex, it's synthetics. If it's not synthetics, we're getting on it on Forex. So as you guys can see, I've been rinsing this strategy throughout the FGMO challenge. As you guys can see, pure wins here. If I just show you there again, and it's just been constantly working, you know. And it's something that was very simple to learn initially, just requires a lot of hard work and dedication. And then once you've and mainly discipline, that's the biggest one out of all of them, guys, I'm gonna say to you guys. But as you guys can see, this trade simply just worked out in our favor, as it should, as expected. And then again, guys, as you look again, look, we have a previous resistance zone, which if we look onto the line chart, look how much traffic it was picking up here. We marked this out, we see this here, we can use the same sort of setup again on that side, but for the opposite bearish structure. As you can see, look, price is starting to reject this now, and this price is starting to, you know, do its thing again. So there you go. I mean, look, price is just respecting each zone, it's making its new zones. And yeah, look, we're just continuing in a bullish manner here, like we expected on the 4 hour, for it to complete the big 4 hour retracement. And obviously price went on and on and on, and we're now, look, we're all the way over here now. And just don't forget to always delete your chart drawings and start fresh all over again. If you're good at your chart drawings, you'll be able to do them over and over and over again, and never, you know, make the same mistake of making them different each time. But again, guys, that's basically it, really. I mean, as you guys could see, we had about four or five strong confluences for a trade that we took, and we're doing everything very basic. We're not trying to overcomplicate things. We're just trying to trace out the moves, see what is on the chart. We're trading what we're seeing. Whatever's visible on the chart is the only thing we're looking at. We're not looking at any other things. We're not trying to go off our feelings. We're not trying to go off our gut instinct. We're simply going off what we're seeing with our eyes, and then we're going off that. And we're not looking too much to refine our entries to a point where we're looking on the 1 minute chart or the 15 second chart. We're just simply looking at the big time frames like this, making our analysis and waiting, because at the end of the day, guys, patience literally pays. I've learned that the hard way, believe me. So as you guys can see, yep, FTMO, something I recommend you guys highly to get into. I will again be going over, you know, the terminology that I used, break and retest, supply and demand, support and resistance, how you guys can flip accounts, how you guys can trade on the bigger time frames, risk management, that's a very important one. And all sorts, guys. If it's not Forex, it's synthetic indices again. It's something where it's price action only, no fundamentals, no news will be affecting your knowledge of the markets. I am streaming every single day now, every single trading day, from the 10th onwards. That's when I'll be doing my verification. Hopefully I'll pass that. On YouTube Live, guys, you won't be missing a thing. I'll actually call out live trades as well, either during London. If it's not for London sessions, it will be either New York, and maybe in New York I'll be trading synthetics possibly, and I'll be making live free trades for you there. And again, last thing, guys, there's a free Telegram in the description below. I highly, highly recommend you guys join that. You guys will be informed on all my latest videos, all my services, things you guys can benefit off. So yeah, I hope you guys found this video useful. If you can, please leave a comment in the description below. Tell me what you want me to do next, what charts you want me to mark up, and I'll be doing that in my lives and in my videos too. So guys, it's been great. I will see you all in the next video. Peace.